Our top focus, Karnataka Chief Minister Jagdish Shettar has met BJP Chief Rajnath Singh after 12 BS Yedurappa loyalists decided to quit the BJP, but both the leaders insist that the meet was nothing more than just a courtesy call and that the BJP government in Karnataka is confident of a majority in the state.
फुल कॉन्फिडेंस के साथ कह सकता हूं कि हमारी कर्नाटक गवर्नमेंट के सामने किसी प्रकार की कोई क्राइसिस नहीं है. हमारी कर्नाटक गवर्नमेंट अपना कार्यकाल पूरा करेगी. डेफिनेटली करेगी. नहीं नहीं नहीं, बस ये केवल कर्सी विजिट. बस कर्सी विजिट. आई थिंक देयर इज नो नीड टू सजेस्ट मिस्टर जगदीश शेट्टर बिकॉज इज वेरी इंटेलिजेंट, वेरी शार्प, वेरी कॉम्पिटेंट चीफ मिनिस्टर. बट आई वुड लाइक टू से ओनली दैट देयर इज नो क्राइसिस बिफोर अवर कर्नाटक
गवर्नमेंट. आई मेट हिम ओनली टू विश हिम फॉर हिज बिकम ए नेशनल प्रेसिडेंट. आई टेकन हिज विशेस फॉर कर्नाटक एज ए लीडर ऑफ द लेजिस्लेटिव पार्टी एंड ओनली जनरल डिस्कशन इज गोइंग. नो अप टिल नाउ नो MLA इज रिजाइंड. So we have to wait and see the what is going on later on. We have to see.
But while Shettar insists that there is no crisis for the BJP in Karnataka, his party has launched a counter attack on 12 rebel MLAs, submitting a complaint with the speaker that seeks their disqualification from the assembly. The speaker will meet the rebel MLAs tomorrow.
These 12 MLAs, they voluntarily resigned from the Bharatiya Janata Party. Their conduct, their behavior, the way they have been behaving in the public, it clearly shows they have voluntarily resigned from the Bharatiya Janata Party. Any person who resigns voluntarily from the party has to be disqualified as per the rules of disqualification. On this ground, we have already filed a petition before the Honorable Speaker. And the copy, we are not actually given hand over the copy to speaker. Petition has been given to secretary. He is the authority to receive our petition. Our request is, we have filed first the petition. It is the duty and obligation of the honorable speaker to first make an order on our petition and then look into their resignation. Therefore, whatever they are claiming that we have given resignation is totally false. It is only a drama. They are making show out of it.
जो ऑल इंडिया भारतीय जनता पार्टी के अध्यक्ष का कहना है, उधर सरकार स्थिर है, तो इससे लगता है भारतीय जनता पार्टी के राष्ट्रीय अध्यक्ष को इस देश के बारे में कितना जानकार रहता है. 14 MLA इस्तीफा देने के बाद बोल रहा है स्थिर है, तो ये राजनीतिक का खोखलेपन दिखता है. इसलिए भारतीय जनता पार्टी के जो हाईकमान है दिल्ली में, ये तुरंत या असेंबली में इसका स्ट्रेंथ प्रूव करना है या मिस्टर शेट्टर जो है मुख्यमंत्री इसको इस्तीफा लेके नया चुनाव के लिए ये जो जाना ठीक है.
All right, Dhanya now joins us for all the latest that is happening politically in Karnataka. Now, Dhanya, we are in fact seeing that the Congress here has launched an attack saying that the BJP government in the state must prove their majority in the Vidhan Sabha. But just do take us through the numbers, how they stack up, and why is the BJP increasingly confident to have the numbers game on their side?
Well, the Karnataka Assembly now has a total of 223 members, which is excluding two vacant seats. That is, so the BJP as of now does have the numbers in case it comes down to vote in the assembly. Now, Yedurappa, as of now, around 13 to 14 MLAs perhaps have identified with him, but that's really not enough to bring down the BJP government. BS Yedurappa will have to get at least support of two or three more MLAs, bring the number to 17 in his favor. That's when the BJP will be in a real crisis. But with many of his supporters like Basavaraj Bommai and Murugesh Nirani now really not coming out in support, it looks like BS Yedurappa is also caught in a quandary. He's not able to muster those numbers, which is why increasingly the BJP is starting to look confident.